Okay, so now we have seen how we can generate a full set of targets that describe the anthropometry of one subject from a predictor defined by user. But we still have some issue. We can have some data from experimental measurement or whatever, but we have still the same issue, is that how we can describe the scaling constraint on the whole human body model to be applied using a deformation method. So in the real world, it just means, okay, I know my target value, this is your value. How is the same measurement on my human body model? How can I measure it? And how I can transform this 1D information in 3D information to drive a transformation. So for that, we had implemented a small module to define the simplified scalable model. First, from the definition of the anthropometric measurement defined in the dataset, for example, for Ansur, as shown before, using some metadata defined in Langmarck, we can simply define on the human body model the various measurements used and defined in the dataset. Here's an example of the Ansur anthropometry defined on the GHBMC. So on this geometrical information, we can make some measurements, some length, width, and circumferences. Then, knowing the target values on the measurement on the human body model, you can, in some local space, you can apply some scaling to length, to circumferences, and so on. And with the anatomical organization of this component of the scalable model, you have in blue an example of a target, a generated target from a full set of targets coming from Ansur dataset. You can also use as target not only dimension value, but you can use also target location coming from whatever you have in your workflow, and you can drive the target value using this target Langmarck location plus some additional anthropometric dimension. So now we'll have some the way to drive, to transform this geometrical information into control point for cruising stuff, for example. So we see in the demo, in this, this slide, we have many options to put some control points on this geometrical component, like this. So for each component, we have defined, okay, for this section, I want to put control point on this location, on this angle. So we have a full set of control points to drive the deformation. And then, using the same module, we can have a preview of what will be the result of the deformation using a preview of the skin, of bone. We can edit target value and put manually some new value to adjust the target or the shape of the deformation. And we can also play with cruising parameters to improve the shape of the deformed model. I will make two small demonstrations. First one, how we can define such measurement on the human body model and show how it can be done easily. How we can interactively adjust values and parameters to have a good quality result of the deformation of the model. So, I will shift to the demonstration. So, this is a GHBMC model. I've defined only four Langmarks. This one at the back of the buttock, two at the knee, and one on the foot. You have the first dimension here to describe the length from the buttock to the knee. You have in white, you have the segments that represent this length. So for each component of the model, you have a set of parameters that help to define the component. For example, for this segment, you have two viewpoints. These viewpoints are defined using Langmarks. And you have option to put or not control point on these viewpoints. For a section is always defined relatively to a segment. I have a segment for the arm, I want to put section at the middle, so it is only a relative position. So we can move it, adjust it, you have some parameter to really follow the description of the dimension in anatomy database. So if I want to add a new one, for example, so just, okay, this is a new component, just edit it. I had viewpoint, okay, it starts here. So I know the name of the Langmarck. I had another viewpoint. It goes to the foot, and this is the new Langmarck. Okay, now I have to organize the tree. How all the dimensions organize? When I change the length of the arm, I need to shift the forearm and the wrist. So this is the three organization of the components. So just we have to edit it and set a parent, okay, this link to the segment tie, like this. Then we can edit, for example, values. This is the current value of the component of the anthropometry on the current HBM. I can change the target value. For example, right now there is no target value. I can increase a big value to show the differences. Like this. Just apply showing the target. And here you have in white the source and in blue the target one. So progressively we can construct really complex model. I will show you this one. This is the Ansure model, the scalable model adapted for Ansure dimension. So there is many dimensions described on it. We have the target. Right now there is no target, but I have preloaded target generated from anthropometry module. So this is green. We have many targets. Just apply it. Okay, I want to use it. It looks good, but I can make a preview of the deformation, for example, just to check if the deformation can be okay for skin, for example. It's really fast. I can check for bone. If necessary, I can adjust some parameter inclusion, but Thomas will present all this stuff later. Or I can change manually, okay, this regarding my environment, regarding what I want to do. This value is not really suitable, so I can change, edit, and change the value. Okay, it's a little bit too low, so I can increase it. So we have the update of the value in the model, and we can check the preview again. Check the preview, this one, to verify that, okay, with this new value, the model looks better. So now I come back to the presentation. To show you a real application performed in a partner of Piper, a lab, and César. So from a pedestrian experiment, they need to scale the model from various types of information, from 3D digitized points during the experiment. We have on the PMFS, we have some anthropometric measurement done on this cadaver. But we can complete this set of measurements using anthropometry module to have a full set of targets that describe the anthropometry. Then they took the Ansure model. Of course, this is not the pedestrian model, but we can adapt it in few minutes to be built the same model, the same scalable model on the pedestrian. And then using the target, we can define the target and apply it to the wall pedestrian model. So we can combine several sources of target in one set of full target, and the scalable model can be adapted very easily to one model to another one. It's just a matter of landmark. So the same model can be applied on different sets. We can, in this paper, we provided the scalable model for JBot, Snyder for child, for Ansure for adult, and the transformation method can define some relevant information to drive the transformation for cruising or other numerical methods. All can be done in the GUI with interactivity and visual feedback of the with the preview. There is a big limitation. We have no cooperation between scalable model and positioning. When the width of the trunk increases, we have to move the arm. So this is not considered in this module, for example. And we need a full set of dimensions to really describe the anthropometry and to drive a deformation. Thank you for your attention.